Good morning, students. I am again here in the class to discuss about the chapter we were doing earlier, that is finance and accounting. In the accounting part, we were doing the accounting part, final account, right? So, in final account, we were discussing about the calculation of gross profit. Last class, we discussed about the calculation of gross profit. I showed you how to calculate it. Gross profit. In short, we call it GP, gross profit. Now, the formula is net profit net sales minus net purchases plus expenses purchases, and one more item is there, that is if we have the opening stock, that is also to be added up. Opening stock, okay, opening inventory, so we will get the amount of gross profit. This is the formula. This is the formula. This must be discussed in our last class. Okay. Now, so this is the formula. Now, what part is to do accounting? Right? And for doing accounting, we need a specific format. Now, see, what is a specific format? I'm telling you, specific format. When to debit credit, when this because we are in accounting world. Gross format now. Right hand side corner, right credit, credit, and left hand side corner, right debit. Here means credit. Divide this into two equal halves. Alright. The left hand side is debit side, right hand side is credit side. This you have no norms. You have learned in class, right. Now, there are two amount columns. Debit amount column, credit amount column. Now, this is the name of this column. This is particular column. particulars. This is amount amount in rupees. Rupees for identification use the symbol presently used or in the correct eyes. Anyone, don't write both. Here. Then on the right hand side, particulars. The heading will go like this. And the top you write in the book of the name of the fonts will be written here. For whom you are being seconding. In the books of if the name is not given, give some dots, put some dots and flip. Otherwise, you can give the name Mrs. X and Company Limited or Singh Brothers, Das Brothers, like this. The name of the font is written like this in this sense. Now, the heading of the statement or the this format. Trading account. Labeling. Trading account for the year ended. When the year in which year they are doing this accounting. Okay. One word, two must be there. And five, this side. Now remember here, the credit side of trading account records the incomes of the business. The first side of income will be sales. That is total sales. Total sales amount will be right here. I told you in our last class that if any sales we can any goods we have sold to our customers, if they have returned some of the out of those goods, some of the goods have been returned by our customers, must be recorded and that must be deducted from the total sales. The less sales returned or return inward now deduct this amount from this and get the net sales value because we need the net sales value. Okay, now come on to the left hand side. All the expenditures will be written here. The first one will write opening stock. This is not expenditure. This opening stock, this is the unsold stock of last year. This we have to understand. This is the unsold stock of last year. Last year we bought this. But at the end of the year, we could not finish the selling, means we could not finish all the goods we bought in the last year. Some of the goods were remaining in our ground. And, but shall we do with those? Shall we throw them out? No. We'll have to sell them this year only. So we'll have to take that into our account. That is the opening stock. So this will be considered this year. This will be the amount of opening stock. We consider as expenditure for the current year also. Write the amount here. Then comes the next item, purchases. Like sales, total purchase for the year is written here. Less sales return. Purchase return how to work. Because we need to take the net value of question or net amount spent on buying goods during the year. This is the net amount of purchase during the year. Then comes other expenditures which are incidental to purchase while buying goods from the manufacturers or from the wholesalers or clearing and forwarding agents. Right? We need to spend some money. That is, we may have to pay wages to our laborers for loading, unloading the goods, for buying goods. We are buying goods, goods are coming through lorry. Those are to be unloaded from the lorry and to be taken to the godown. For that, the person who will engage in this work, they will have to pay certain money. That is standard wages. So that will be the expenditure relating to purchase, wages. Single and local GPM. Right? If you are buying goods from outside the country, you have to pay some import duty. As you are buying goods and bringing the goods through lorry, so carriage is to be given. This is carriage. You want in this way some more items are there, freight charges are there, your light, fuel, power, these are there, many items are there. You person who will find those items, right? So all those items are to be written on the left hand side, that is on the expenditure side. And lastly, see, the first item is opening stock. What I told, this is the amount, this is the item on stock of last year, unsold stock. This year also we have bought certain goods, right? And we are doing this at the end of the year, that is written here. And then, now, in this year, if some of the goods are left unsold in the godown, what will you do? We have not spent those much money for those goods we bought, isn't it? So that is also to be calculated and to be taken into consideration, to be taken into account. What can we do? We can deduct it from here. Straightway, or we can write it on the other side. This is the convention, we write it on the right hand side as closing stock. Same thing, same amount, same calculation can be done. We can deduct it from purchase amount or net purchase amount, the amount of unsold stock. We can deduct it from this side of the question. But the convention, our convention is the unsold stock or closing stock, we should write on the right hand side of the trading account. This way, the trading account is prepared. Alright. Now, some work is left still. What are the works we have to do? We have to balance both the sides, the debit side and the credit side. What we have to do is, we have to add up both the sides. Now, which side is heavier? You decide. Apparently, you decide which side is heavier. If this side is heavier, add up this side. Generally, the income is more, income we earn in a business, generally becomes more than the expenditure. So, this side will be heavier in most cases. Okay? Sometimes the reverse can happen. So, you change accordingly.
to add up this side first, take this total, bring it onto this side, write it there, here. Okay. You take this figure onto this side. Okay. Now, add these figures and deduct the total of these from this total, and the balance you will get right here. The difference amount, right this side. Now, this is your gross profit of your business. Now, this gross profit is to be transferred to the other account number. At the end of preparation of this trading account, we need to close this account. But for closing this, we need to transfer this balance into another account or profit and loss account. So we write here to profit and loss account within bracket gross profit transfer. Okay. This is your transfer. This gross profit is to be transferred to profit and loss account. This is here, trading account. Now, if the year is mentioned, write it here. Otherwise, put some dots on it. Is that okay? Now, what you have to do is you have to practice some problems. You have to practice some problems at home. This item is going to be given. How do we prepare this? Loop we are given is, or a question we are given is, we are given the parallels. We are given a trial balance, right? We are given a trial balance. On the basis of the trial balance, we have to prepare this. Understood? On the basis of that trial balance, we have to prepare this. In the trial balance, all the items will get except closing stock. Closing stock does not find any place in the trial balance. This you have learned in class 9 syllabus. Okay? The closing stock will be outside the trial balance. All other items will be within the trial balance. And from that, we have to select which are the items to be recorded in trading account on the debit side and which are the items to be recorded on the credit side of trading account. And accordingly, when we add up both sides, the balance is, the balancing figure is not as gross profit or gross loss. It is a gross loss. Debit side total will be more. So add up this side, take the total onto this side, deduct this balances from this total, the balance you will get, you will write here as, and this will be your gross loss for the year. Is that clear? So for today, up to this, in our next class, we will discuss about the next step. That is profit and loss account. Now for today, we are giving you some homework. Record this as homework. So, one or two problem. from there. On trading account. This is your homework. Okay? This is your homework. If you find any problem, contact me directly. Okay? That's all. Thank you very much. Thank you.